Okay. Don't mind what you're seeing right now. I'm just kind of testing some things out. Okay. I believe we are good. Ah, you can't play it. You can't play it windowed. Fuck. That actually kind of sucks. All right. Let's begin. Holy fuck. Okay, hold up. Oh, dear lord. That is very loud. I need to turn that shit down. Hold up. Volume down. Okay. Right. All right. Hello, everyone. It's Snake. And today, I am going to be playing a new game that was sent to me by the developer. If you don't know Risk, they're a friend of mine. We played Clone Hero together on a stream. And I also gave them music lessons. And they're working on a new game, which looks like this. I have no idea what to expect, because I've seen pictures, but that's about it. So how to play. Aim your shooter at the falling blocks that fall to the rhythm of the music. If you miss, you'll hit your HUD, which will decrease your health. Okay. I feel like this could do without the shooter fading out and back in. And it would be better if it just, like, stayed instead of fading out and in, so then the animation would be a perfect loop, but whatever. That can be fixed later on down the line. Okay, oh, I used the mouse wheel to scroll through. Okay. Yes. I know you saw something else here. We'll get to that in a bit. Okay, so difficulty on that one is hard. I want to start with an easier song for this. So this is an OSU catch-style game. The only thing is, it's actually better than catch, because you get to use your mouse to control it. The biggest gripe I had about OSU Catch is that, OSU Catch controls with the arrows, which is not very, like, you can't get very precise or rapid movement. Because in OSU Catch, you're bound to moving at a constant speed, and I don't like that. So this is a lot more intuitive, and it's a lot easier to compensate when you make mistakes. Cool. So I got 55 out of 60. I feel like I could FC that. We'll start the video off with an FC, why not? There we go. I FC'd it. Second try. Pew pew. Alright, we have one more track to go before we get to the exciting part, so I'm gonna show this off first. What was the time on this? A minute and a half? Difficulty was normal, so let's see how this goes. Shit. Whoops. What am I doing? Okay. Ah! God damn it. Okay, wow. That is actually a significant difficulty, difficulty jump. Jesus Christ. Oh, and it starts the level over automatically. That's actually a nice touch. What the fuck? Okay. Yeah, so if you're meant to play the songs from left to right, this difficulty jump is way too much. Like, going from that first song to this one, that is a very steep difficulty spike. I will attempt to pass this, though. If I can. Okay, what's throwing me off is the speed at which the, Okay, yeah, what's throwing me off there is the speed at which the cubes come in. It's really, like, obfuscating the pattern. Or, it's obfuscating the pattern and the rhythm, that you need to move your little shooter around at. Okay, yeah, so I'm immediately, I'm seeing some problems with this chart. The problem I'm seeing with this chart straight away is, if I exit out to the song selection. Yeah, so this is an easy chart, and I agree, I was able to pass it on sight read, and I FC'd it second try. But if this is your idea of normal, then, yeah, that's just not, like, I passed this chart on sight read, I cannot pass this one. So, the difficulty, if you're meant to play these charts from left to right like this, which it appears that you're meant to, because this is a hard chart, that's also a hard chart, and then we have some normal charts here. And then, oh, that one's hard, okay, I'm not looking forward to that then. But, I would say this is more of a hard chart than a normal chart, because, yeah, if this is easy and this is normal, the difficulty increase between this chart and this chart is, like, way too much. Alright, so we've got the exciting part of this game now, which is that this is my song. My song is in the game. And this is a hard chart, so if Excite was a fucking normal chart, I am not looking forward to how this is gonna go, but... Oh, okay, we're starting straight away. Ah! Okay. How did I fail that already? What? Okay. I think I'm starting to pinpoint the cause of the problem. Okay, maybe my mouse sensitivity is too high, hold up. Let's try turning it down. God damn it, okay. Alright, let's go back to a normal chart. Maybe the normal chart I chose is just on, like, the higher end of the normal difficulty. Okay, this one's much easier than the previous one, I can already tell. Wait, what? Okay, that's cube dropped in first, that was a little strange. Oh god, okay. Come on. Thank you. Okay. Managed to pass that one. So, here are my thoughts so far on this, just from those few songs that I played. One thing I know for sure is that I cannot pass False Angel. Unless I get some more practice in and maybe adjust my mouse settings a little bit. Also, I need to turn this down even more. This is like one of the loudest rhythm games I've ever played out of the box. Okay, so here's my personal message to Risk on how I feel about this game so far. It's better than OSU Catch because you get to control it using the mouse rather than the arrows. That was my biggest gripe about OSU Catch, but I have a few minor complaints about this game. Number one, any new player to the game will intuitively think that the progression goes from the song on the left of the selection menu to the song on the right. And if they go through the difficulty jump from Elysium to Excite, they're going to drop the game as soon as they start struggling to pass Excite. Because they're going to realize if this is the idea of what easy is supposed to be, and then Excite is supposed to be normal, that's a massive difficulty jump that's way too big. So Excite either needs to be made, or it needs to be tagged as hard instead of normal, or a different song needs to be put in Excite's position, which I'd recommend. So first suggestion I have is to order the songs by difficulty rather than this order that seems somewhat arbitrary. The second point I have is that as the developer of the game, you're going to be far more intimately familiar with some of the gameplay quirks and how they work. So you may not catch certain things like this, but if this game is meant to be picked up by casual rhythm gamers, the hit windows and HP drain are absolutely brutal, especially for someone like myself who is touching this style of rhythm game where it's controlled by the mouse rather than the keyboard for the first time. So what I would say to remedy that is twofold. Number one, make the cubes bigger, or in the chart editor, have a way to change the size of the cubes. And number two, make it so that if you miss a cube, there isn't as much health drain. Yeah, I feel like also when you miss a cube, you're losing like three times as much health, or maybe even more than that, than you gain when you actually hit a cube. Which may be fine on harder levels, but for this to be the default difficulty throughout the entire game, that might be way too hard for a casual rhythm gamer picking this up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it only takes about 11 misses to fail the level. And if you miss a really complicated pattern and you're desperately trying to catch up, you're gonna fall behind and lose really quick, especially on the songs with harder, faster patterns. So, I mean, if you're gearing this game towards avid rhythm gamers who are like really good at this kind of stuff, like they play, I don't know, 10 stars on OSU Standard, then that's fine. But if you want this game to have a broader appeal to a casual audience, you need to nerf the HP drain a little bit, maybe make the cubes bigger on easier difficulties, and I guess overall just create more options that will make the early game more accessible. So this is like a perfect introductory chart. I just FC'd it again. But yeah, going from Elysium to Excite, which is the intuitive progression, was an extremely jarring difficulty jump. So I'd recommend putting a different track in this spot and ordering them by difficulty. And on that note, okay, let's try another song and see exactly what the difficulty is like. We'll be right back. So on songs where I'm like, on songs where I'm like passing, but I am still missing a lot of notes, like, I think Mirror was the example I came out with. On songs like those, it feels like I'm hanging by a thread, just because of how little room for error there is in the general gameplay. Again, given the fact that there's such a harsh HP drain, and recovery when you start hitting more notes is really slow. Okay, well, this one is way out of my skill range, so I'm not even gonna attempt it. Awesome that one of my songs is in the game, though. So, I'm gonna round this video off. I know I only played a handful of the tracks, but, I mean, Excite is out of my skill level. Pulse and Robot Arcade are both hard tracks, so I'm not even gonna attempt those, because I'll probably just fail them instantly. Which means I can play 3 out of the 7 songs in this collection. So, what I'm gonna start with is what I like about this game, because there's a lot to like. First thing, which I sort of neglected to mention until now, is the game is very, very responsive. Like, when I move my mouse, it really feels like the game is matching my movements without, like, any sort of delay or anything like that. I'm not sure how easy it would be to work some sort of offset setting into the game, but given that the only input the game is reliant on is mouse movement, I don't think an offset setting will be too big a deal unless you're starting to play at, like, stuff that's beyond comprehension right now. Another thing I really like about this game is the overall aesthetic. This, like, neon sort of glowy effect with the very sort of regular geometric shapes in the background is just, like, I mean, if you've ever seen any of the album covers for my releases as Stability, you'll know why I love this style so much. And finally, the song selection. The song selection for this early release is amazing. Like, it's not... I feel like it's not often that we get song selections this good in an early access version of a rhythm game. So... now I want to talk about the changes that I'd suggest to this game. And many of these are going to be under the assumption that the intent of this game is to eventually have a widespread appeal that can be started out on by casual players. Number one biggest thing, for the overall game, or maybe even just the easier tracks, make the cubes bigger and make the HP drain less severe. Even when I'm playing an easy song like this one, I feel like I can't miss. Because if I do, then I'll start fumbling the rest of the patterns. And all of my HP will have been completely drained and I'll fail the song before I can even catch up. So, playing through even the easiest of songs can be a harrowing experience. The next recommendation is to make some adjustments to the difficulty ratings of the songs in general. Like, this one is definitely a hard song, and these two are definitely normal. But this, I feel like, should be a hard song instead of a normal one. And on the point of rating the songs by difficulty, these songs are all arranged in what feels like a very arbitrary manner. When the intuitive progression in a game like this, with this kind of layout, is to play the songs from left to right. So, a player who's completely unfamiliar with a game will play Elysium, pass it on maybe their second or third try, and then if they get to Excite, see that it's a normal song, and experience that massive difficulty jump, that may not be very encouraging for them to want to play the game much longer. And the final point, which I'm pretty sure it's going to be addressed in the future development, because it's like just after the very first version of the public test build, is we need an options menu. I am a little frustrated at having to play this game in full screen, and I have no way to window it as far as I can tell. Even my like window resizing software doesn't do anything. But overall, there is a lot of potential in this game. The gameplay experience is already extremely smooth. The game is very responsive to your mouse movements. You know, there are no dropped hits where, like, if you hit a cube, it's not like the game just decides to not register it. So, when you're on target, it will know that you're on target, which is a very good thing. Friday Night Funkin' didn't do that on its first release. I think I need to start looking into more mouse-controlled rhythm games, because this is actually a really fun side of rhythm gaming that I haven't explored yet. I haven't even touched, like, a single chart in OSU Standard. So maybe that could be something to play to get my mouse rhythm game fix while I wait for more content for Rhythm Bank to come out. But overall, I can definitely recommend the public test build for this game to anyone who wants to experience a brand new rhythm game and experience a unique twist on a rhythm game that really isn't that much appreciated, but this definitely makes it like 10 times better. So a link to the Discord server where you can download the game will be in the description. I'll also include a link to Risk's channel. They're the developer of the game. Like I said, they're also my friend. I've played Clone with Hero with them and given them music lessons. And yeah, that'll be about it. I've been Lee Snigrox, and I will see you all later. Thank you for watching.